Good afternoon, everybody. Please be seated. As academic registrar, it is both my privilege and pleasure to welcome you all to the Cambridge Corn Exchange for this afternoon's ARU graduation ceremony. We've all gathered here today to celebrate the success of the class of 2022. Now, I think it's fair to say that your experience of higher education has been on the more unconventional side, grappling as you have with the disruption caused by the COVID-19 pandemic. But it is a testimony to your commitment to your studies that you're seated here now, waiting to participate in your graduation ceremony. So from all of us, many congratulations on simply completing your studies in such unprecedented circumstances. So now that you're here, what is this all about? Well, graduation ceremonies date back to the 15th century, and the tradition has evolved since. Roughly translated, graduation means taking a step. And graduation symbolizes the move of the former student, now called a graduand, into a new role in society as a graduate, where they will use the skills and talents developed during their studies to contribute to the future advancement of society. As each graduand crosses the stage, they will pause, bow their head, and doff their hat to the Chancellor or Vice-Chancellor, who will respond in kind to acknowledge both their success and their transition to the new role of graduate. We will applaud them for their success so far, but also in anticipation of the contribution we expect them to make to society in the future. At the conclusion of our ceremony, the Vice-Chancellor will formally admit all new graduates to the community of scholars. And as new members of that community, as the academic procession leaves the stage, the new graduates will join the procession, and that will bring our ceremony to a close. During proceedings, those graduating with higher research awards will have their hoods placed upon them by the Chancellor or Vice-Chancellor to indicate that they have attained the very highest levels of academic achievement. So it is now time for us to begin our formal proceedings. I hereby declare the ceremony to be in session, and I call upon the Chancellor, Lord Ribeiro, to address you all. Chancellor.
Distinguished graduates, guests, family, friends, colleagues. As Chancellor of Anglo-Ruskin University, it is my very great pleasure to join you today at your graduation ceremony. Your graduation marks a successful completion of your course. It recognizes your achievement and welcomes you as a member of our community of scholars. For many, it also makes a major transition from the world of study to the world of work, one of which our students have proved to be exceptionally capable. You should be very proud of all that you have achieved, despite the challenges you've had to face along the way, the pandemic being one of them. You are undoubtedly more resilient than you were, and that resilience can now be applied to realizing your ambitions. I'm proud and privileged to be associated with Anglia Ruskin University, and I hope you feel the same. Anglia Ruskin University is your university for life, and I sincerely hope your graduation is the start of the next chapter of your relationship with us. So congratulations on all you have achieved so far. We are extremely proud of you.
Chancellor, thank you. I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor, Professor Roderick Watkins, to address you all. Vice-Chancellor.
As Vice-Chancellor of Anglia Ruskin University, I am delighted to join you this afternoon at your graduation ceremony. And firstly, to all those graduating today, my congratulations on reaching this milestone and graduating from your chosen course. Today is a day of great celebration. It's an opportunity for each of you to take stock, reflect, and celebrate your achievements to date, but also to look forward to the exciting careers that stretch out in front of you. And whatever career you enter, you are the future. You now have the opportunity and the responsibility to embrace and promote change, to implement new ideas and new ways of working. The passion, energy, and commitment that led you to undertake your AIU degree and gave you the strength to succeed in that task, despite all the challenges you'll have faced, including those posed by this dreadful pandemic, can now be applied to building your careers and realizing your aspirations. And whether your future lies in education, health, social care, law, or business, with your passion and your expertise, you really can now make a difference, helping society to address the challenges that we all face. And we will have succeeded in our task if we have helped you to develop the skills, confidence, and the determination to influence and lead your professions to promote change and to achieve your ambitions. As well as serving our students, we at ARU are fully committed to serving our region and the communities in which we're based. Economic development, social inclusion, business support, tackling health inequalities, these are all fundamentally important elements of our mission, transforming lives through innovative, inclusive, and entrepreneurial education and research. And despite all the challenges that we have all faced together, we have had another highly successful year at ARU. We have opened a new university in Peterborough, ARU Peterborough. And we've welcomed our first cohort of new students just 2 months ago. And this new university will provide life-changing opportunities for thousands of local people who may not previously have considered degree-level study. And it will deliver a skilled local workforce that will meet employers' needs. Also, last year, we were awarded the Queen's Anniversary Prize. That's the highest award that a university can win in the national honours system. We were awarded that prize for our world-leading research in music therapy, and in particular, our research with and for people living with dementia and their families. In January, we opened the UK's first Samaritans University Hub here on our Cambridge campus, and the Chelmsford Hub will be opening soon. And in April, we were ranked first in the UK and 20th in the world out of more than 1,100 universities for the impact of our work in health and well-being in the Times Higher Education Impact Rankings. And our reach extends well beyond our region. We are a genuinely global community of students and researchers, and we attract students from over 135 countries. And they flourish with us because they find a second home here. And our researchers, too, have worldwide reach and impact. And in this year's National Research Excellence Framework, 16 of our research areas were rated as including world-leading research. And our researchers are tackling real-world issues, from improving internet safety for teenagers to changing the lives of people living with dementia, from developing compassionate resilience in healthcare workers to addressing the global burden of eye disease. And our researchers responded rapidly to the outbreak of the COVID-19 pandemic by committing to research that would help us to understand and develop interventions to address the massive impact that the pandemic was having on all our communities. And their research included ways into speeding up coronavirus testing, research into how COVID-19 affects the eyes, how it makes tinnitus worse, and an investigation into innovative drug combinations that can reduce complications in COVID-19 patients. So in our research, as in our education, we are having real, tangible impact on people's lives, and that's something of which we can all be really proud. But above all, we define our success as a university by the positive impact we have on the lives of our students and the students and the communities we serve. And for us to succeed, we will need your support as our newest alumni. Because the support we receive from our students, it really matters. Adding value to the education we can provide our students and supporting our researchers to push boundaries. So please help us. Help us to build links with your networks and your professions. And please spread the good word about your university. Before I close, I would please like to pay special tribute to your families and friends who have provided you with their constant support throughout your education. You and we owe them our sincere gratitude. So please join me in thanking them. And I would please also like to thank and acknowledge my colleagues, the staff right across ARU, for their tireless work and professionalism and their extraordinary commitment to supporting you and all in our community through the challenges of the pandemic. So once again, my warm congratulations to you all. I do hope you enjoy your day. I wish you well wherever your ARU degree takes you, and please do stay in touch. ARU is your university for life, and our success and your success are inextricably linked. Thank you.
Vice Chancellor, thank you. So we now come to our main business for this afternoon's ceremony, the presentation of those receiving awards. And I now call upon Dean of Faculty, Professor Denise Hawkes, to come to the podium to present to the Chancellor graduates from the Faculty of Business and Law. Professor Hawkes.
Chancellor, it is my pleasure to present to you graduates from the Faculty of Business and Law. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, Management and Leadership, Curtis Samuel Shand. For the award of Masters of Business Administration, Azan Mohammed Mataib Al-Shahri. Amir Fatel Abdullah Mohammed Abdullah Tefi. Lee Duk Thin. Lena Tehai. Sandra Zan. For the award of Bachelor of Science with Honours Economics, Yobosi Francis Amekyekwabong. Tahibu Rahman. for the award of Bachelor of Science with Honours International Business Management, Faisal Abdul Jabbar Al-Imam. Charlie Luca Bila. Alexander Evan Anna V. Maurizio Bucchetti. And also receiving the ARU CP Certificate for Professional Development, Sasha Chanhal. Also receiving the ARU CP Certificate for Professional Development, Julia Cheslek. Kimberly L. Melder. Maria Lina Grenada Kundat Porto. Also receiving the ARU Certificate for Professional Development, Francesco Migini Alukunwa. Telek Telek Sakaganov. Akashama. For the award of Bachelor of Laws with Honours Law, Rhys Sean Lewis Ashop. Orin Lee Kikanka. Tajit Singh. Tajit Singh Nita. Hannah Patel. Rebecca Marillis. Rafael Goncalves. For the award of Master of Science International Business, Varaj Singh. Athulichi Bala Paramli Nidinash. Rofit Ola Bukula Bella. Aya Chandid. Sri Chandana Chali Parambi Garlic. Thomas Hosin William Dalbar. Jose George. Rachel Beth Hayter. Justin Jose. Lavish Joseph. Ishmael Mohammed Yella Asha Mohammed. Shin Mo. Maruth Yad Jaya Radin Manji. Nandathin Nandan. Mitu Pushta Sad. Govin Ravin. Henzi Primo Victoria Pereira. Navjot Singh. Sapna Sumaranma. Akshay Sheenresh. Vikhil Van Getty. Kristimon Vagarash. Bathraj Vitarathrad Paru Ramchandru. Fleming Wilson. For the award of Masters of Laws, International Business Law, Jocelyn Joseph. Ramesh Kodari. Michelle Ishwari Pareri Mararadi Yadi. Akshay Sharedu Middleton. Peter Takor Cho. For the award of International Business, for the award of Masters of Laws, International Commercial Law, Janet Jude Cass. Israel Reward Washti Mati Yanga. Temi Topi Samson Ojo. For the award of Masters of Laws International Law, Shukai Hai Lachmush. Hannah Tu Lazarus Mingi. Ladybird Amakwa Sarkira Odi. For the award of Postgraduate Diploma Legal Practice, Luchi Kramer. Chloe Goody. Samantha Louise Jones. Ajil Kama Doshosh. George Allen Wright. and from the award of Masters of Science International Business, Aleph George. Chancellor, it's my pleasure to present those who've been awarded higher research degrees. For the award of Doctor of Philosophy with a thesis entitled The Perceptions of Key Stakeholder Groups on How Transnational Higher Education Contributes to Building a Knowledge-Based Economy in a Developing Country, Mohammed Shama Mohammed Sharif. Members of the family of Anwar Bagel will collect an Antradat Award for a Doctor of Philosophy for their family member. Chancellor, that completes the list of graduands for me to present to you today. Thank you.
Professor Hawkes, thank you. We continue with our main business, the presentation of those receiving awards, by calling on Pro Vice Chancellor and Dean of Faculty, Professor Nigel Harrison, to come to the podium to present to the Chancellor graduates from the Faculty of Health, Education, Medicine and Social Care. Professor Harrison.
Chancellor, it is my pleasure to present to you graduates from the Faculty of Health, Education, Medicine, and Social Care. For the award of Bachelor of Science with Honours, Acute Care, Kimberly Dawson. For the award of Foundation Degree in the Sciences, Assistant Practitioner, Nursing, Andrea Bartolo. Julie Helen Bloy Cook. Jamuna Bura. Charlemagne Chiderly. Lily Sophie Jackson. Elena Kathleen Martin. Amanda Jane Nightingale. Phoebe Jean Perry. Daniel Sikai Zivivu. For the award of Bachelor of Science with Honours, Midwifery, Eleanor Banahan. Catherine Borley. Sadie Breed. Maya Isabel Breach North. Naomi Louise Brown. Natasha Chinahamu. Olivia Grace Clark. Hannah Karen Crisp. Joanna Louise Crowther. Jennifer Ann Curry. Erica Doherty. Shannon Duchar. Daniela Eames. Aisling Claire Ellis. Zoe Evans. Pamela Heather Hamilton. Felicity Harmer. Fadi Leshai. Caroline Loveridge. Lucy Morris. Zoe Amber Postlewaite. Laura Jane Taylor. Kirsty Ann Telford. Elena Abigail Twaits. Saffron Paris A. Tovey. Sophie Walters. For the award of Bachelor of Science with Honours, Nursing, Adult, Madison Carlene Andrews. Rochelle Avanzado. Anna Bacon. Elena Katie Bissand. Mia Louise Blank. Naomi Boyza. Claire Allison Brown. Raylene Helen Burbridge. Mary Chinyama. Nicola Jade Chirilaku. Zoe Kendall Lee Connor. Lindsay Evangelista. Alexandra Kate Farnhill. Hishu Hammer. Kelly Horson. Samantha Henderson. Myri Hamu Jallo Diallo. Shirian Johnson. Eve Sarah E. Limming. No Lusinga. Joanna Marcus Miguel. Catherine Mateig. Sally Louise McCrath. Jamie Princess Mingle. Nabla Marada. Eloise Morgan. Shauna Geraldine Murray. Shailene Mutemanga. Memory TM. Mukozai Nakub. Bernard Nashena. Charlotte Jennifer O'Neill. Amy Oxley. Amber Pillinger. Emily Grace Pratt. Danielle Roberts. Tamara Ruiz Criado. Ingrida Sabien. Minsa Mariam Salu. Dembo Sana. Dijen Sherpa. Chancellor, that partially completes the list of graduates for me to present to you today.
Professor Harrison, thank you. Each year, Anglia Ruskin University confers a number of honorary awards on individuals outstanding in their field of endeavor and who we hope will act as a source of inspiration to those of you crossing the platform today. Their stunning achievements should make us realize that our own success to date is merely a starting point, and they pose the question, should we too not aspire to success such as theirs? I now call upon ARU's Chair of the Board of Governors, Keith Atwood, to come to the podium to read the citation for the award of Doctor of Health Sciences honoris causa to Professor Ian Martin.
It's my pleasure to read the citation for Professor Ian Martin for the award of Honorary Doctor of Health Sciences. Professor Martin is Vice-Chancellor of Deakin University in Australia and former Vice-Chancellor of our Anglia Ruskin University. Born in South Wales, Ian spent much of his childhood in Hampshire. He studied medicine at the University of Leeds and remained in the city to complete his postgraduate studies in surgery. He was appointed lecturer in surgery at Leeds University and later consultant surgeon at Leeds General Infirmary. His clinical focus was primarily on gastrointestinal cancer and minimally invasive surgical techniques. Yet during his time in Leeds, Ian also developed a broader interest in the field of higher education, which was to shape the second part of his career. In 2000, Ian seized the opportunity to gain valuable international experience, accepting the role of Professor of Surgery at the University of Auckland, New Zealand. And over the next decade, he went on to hold a variety of roles at Auckland University as Head of Surgery, Head of the School of Medicine, Dean of the Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences, and as Deputy Vice Chancellor with responsibility for external and international engagement. In 2012, Professor Martin was appointed Deputy Vice Chancellor Academic at the University of New South Wales in Sydney. And over the next 3.5 years, he transformed the university's approach to teaching and learning with heightened emphasis on the innovative use of digital resources. In 2016, after an exhaustive international recruitment exercise to identify a candidate who could lead our university into a new phase of growth, Professor Martin was appointed Vice Chancellor of Anglia Ruskin University. And so, armed with his extensive experience, a talent for innovation, and a desire to create a transformative educational experience for our students, he set to building his vision of a leading learning and innovation ecosystem. During his time at ARU, Professor Martin helped to build and nurture vibrant university communities, strengthening our operations and ultimately helping to create a university that has become greater than the sum of its parts. Under his leadership, ARU made huge progress in providing excellent education and pastoral support for our students, whilst continuing to enhance the impact of our research. He championed our values of innovation and promoted stronger links with our local community and regional communities. And crucially, he played a major role in delivering Essex's first School of Medicine. In the summer of 2018, Ian left ARU to take up a fresh challenge as Vice Chancellor of Deakin University in Australia. Professor Martin, once an accomplished physician and surgeon, is now a visionary academic leader with long-standing links to our university. He will be an inspirational role model for our students. We are delighted to welcome back Professor Ian Martin to our Anglia Ruskin community. Chancellor, it is my pleasure to present Professor Ian Martin for the award of Doctor of Health Sciences, honoris causa.
Thank you so much, Bernard. Yeah. It's a real honour. I am truly humbled.
Of Anglia Ruskin University, I hereby confirm on you, Professor Ian Martin, an award of Doctor of Health Sciences, honoris causa. And as a surgeon, to a fellow surgeon, it gives me great pleasure to do so.
Thank you so much. You're going to do your... Thank you. Thank you. I think I'll leave that with you.
You do.
A strange sense of deja vu here for me. Chancellor, Vice Chancellor, honoured guests, and most importantly of all, the graduands here today. Being here today to celebrate your achievements and your graduation is simply wonderful. I'm truly humbled by ARU's conferral of my ONDOC today. It means a very great deal to me. Graduation has always been a very significant milestone, but for you and your class, much of the last 3 years has been anything but normal, and today, consequently, should be even more special for you. I know at my own university now, we hosted our first formal indoor graduation ceremonies for 2.5 years in October, and the joy I saw in the faces then is replicated in the joy in the faces here in the room now. Now, hosting graduation ceremonies is a significant logistical exercise, and timekeeping is really important. And it's quite nice to be on this side of the fence. I know all too well that at this point in the ceremony, those sitting behind me now in the organising team are really, really hoping that the speaker has read their instructions and sticks to time. I can reassure you I have, and my lecture for the next 30 minutes will be used well. But seriously, I have only a few minutes, and I want to focus on just a few key thoughts. I graduated on a warm June day in Leeds in 1987. We haven't quite replicated the warmth, but the celebration is here. I could never have imagined where life would take me from there. Absolutely never could have imagined. And that underlies my first suggestion to you. By all means, have plans, aspirations, ideas, but be open to them changing, paths diverging, and new opportunities open up. As I look back on the past 35 years, I can absolutely say the most professional joy and excitement I've had has come from the opportunities I never saw coming. Over that time, I've met and worked with some of the most amazing people. And it was so often those whose journeys and careers were most different from mine that I learned the most. This extended not just in the countries I was working to, but those I visited. One of the enormous privileges of my university leadership roles has been the ability to travel and nurture overseas partnerships and relationships. Engaging with different cultures, backgrounds, and environments left me noting the differences, but far more often acknowledging just how similar people are around the globe. The conversations around the table, the aspirations for family, and the hopes and concerns for the future were nearly always the same. That common human bond is something to be acknowledged and cherished. Sadly, all too often, media, politicians, and vested interests play out the differences. But all of us, including you, our graduates today, have a responsibility to make sure we draw ourselves together whenever we can. That's not the same as saying everything is the same, but understanding those differences is not always without challenges. Just one story to illustrate this came when I moved in 2000 to New Zealand, and I was caring for a young Pacific Islander. He had a very serious diagnosis, and I needed to talk through what that meant for him. Now, my training, and I suspect many of the health professionals in the room today, you will have emphasized the primacy of that individual relationship with the patient. But in his culture, it was different. His culture emphasized that such meetings were always held in a large family group. I learned so much from seeing just how different that dynamic was, but also ultimately how much I learned from engaging with the entire family. Over the last 3 decades, I have worked with some incredible leaders and mentors, not least at ARU. And I've learned much, and I'm going to give you 3 short lessons. Firstly, leadership. Leadership matters, and senior leaders make a real difference. It's what my mentor called Big L leadership. But what I've learned over the years is that what is more important are organizations that enable what he called small L leaders to flourish. These are people who come to work and make a difference in their part of the organization. They make their organization better through small changes that enhance things. And as you build your own careers, make sure that you champion that small L leadership and seek out organizations that enable you to do just that. Secondly, values. Values really matter. And I worked with a senior leader in a defense organization who's dealing with some very challenging values-based issues. And he had a simple line. It was very easy to say, but very hard to live to. The values you walk by are the values you accept. If it's not right, do something about it. It's not easy, but I can assure you it really matters. So often, when one person speaks out, others follow. But things never change if no one starts. Be the person who starts that. And finally, change. The Vice Chancellor mentioned change in his introductory speech. Throughout your degree, you've had to navigate ongoing changes to course restrictions, lockdowns, all of the things we've had to navigate. It's tested your ability to respond and adapt. You've shown enormous resilience in getting to where you've got to do today and through your studies. Whether it's COVID-19 or one of the many challenging global events unfolding, our world continues to evolve and change. And as they often say, change is the only constant. Now, when I was growing up, I was a science fiction nerd, and I loved Isaac Asimov. He was well known for peering into the far future and imagining the world that might be. And one of his thoughts seems to be a take home for the world right now. It is change, continuing change, inevitable change, that is the dominant factor in society today. No sensible decision can be made any longer without taking into account not only the world as it is, but the world as it will be. It's very easy to be resistant to that change. We have to be careful not to mistake change for progress for change's sake, but we must also be willing to see change as the bringer of opportunities and renewal, rather than as always an undesirable and destructive force. Wherever your career takes you, navigating change and sometimes instigating change will be your constant future as professionals and leaders. In finishing, I return to where I started. You should be particularly proud of how you've handled the extraordinary challenges of the last few years. Congratulations, and wherever your journey takes you from here, I wish you all the best. Well done to every single one of you. It is a remarkable achievement. And as the Vice Chancellor said, your future and ARU's future are, for better or worse, inextricably linked. Make both of them as glorious as possible. Well done.
Professor Martin, thank you and congratulations. We now continue with our main business for this afternoon's ceremony, the presentation of those receiving awards. And I now call upon Pro Vice Chancellor and Dean of Faculty, Professor Nigel Harrison, to return to the podium to present to the Vice Chancellor graduates from the Faculty of Health, Education, Medicine and Social Care. Professor Harrison.
Vice Chancellor, it is my pleasure to continue the presentations of graduates from the Faculty of Health, Education, Medicine and Social Care. For the award of Bachelor of Science with Honours, Nursing Adult, Cara Lee Smith. Adika Tariq. Dimitro Gabriel Vizilin. Leanne Amanda Wilkinson. Mavis Yeboah. Caroline Shrewadza. For the award of Bachelor of Science with Honours, Nursing, Child, Jessica Chisholm Udika. Hannah Jade Blackburn. Amy Castro. Megan Jade Wilson-Clark. Rebecca Drover. Yasmin Yvonne Bridget Ferguson. Lauren Gardner. Elizabeth Lucy Gears Pratton. Sarah Haddo. Emma High. Sadia Hickbell. Emily Susan Jarvis. Aoife Kiley. Lauren Marie Lowerings. Abby Rhiannon Molyneux. Georgina Emmeline Moxon. Sarah Nerdine. Bazira Naziri. Saski Newman. Nana Oduru Ayiwa. Yasmin Victoria Perfect. Grace Temiloluwa Otimi. Sally Slater. Michelle Uger Bone. Yeah. Shannon Chloe Wharton. Noel Buerd. For the award of Bachelor of Science with Honours, Nursing, Mental Health, Mary Ocon Akana Inyen. Obulanli Shakirat Akinsanya. Don Audlia Manliklik Amaranto. Odiolu Olajumok Atanda. Trinity Jane V. Bailey. Chloe Jade Berry. File Sean Delas Santos Castillo. Chido Chifamba. Olachai Clara Oteruam Echibima. Imogen Sophie Alice Haley. Memory Marowidza. Nelson Mate Madombo. Abiteo Mbachu. Louise Rosemary Miller. Emma Jane Morgan. Monica Mucono. Rita Muro Yiwa. Christopher Azzi Obihibo Thomas. George Obonyo. Amyadat Oliseyi Omosibi. Ifa Ayi Rex Oson. Derek Tafuma. Angela Wanjaiku Wawiru Holland. Lillian William. For the award of Master of Science, Advanced Practice, Clinical, Lauren Sarah Campbell. Holly Georgia Clark. Emily Rose Dagger. Abigail Florence Early. Susan George. Catherine Louise Hedicar. Simba Kazanji. For the award of Postgraduate Certificate, Critical Care, Neethu Elizabeth Jacob. Anastasia Panopoulou. Maria Buena Perez. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, Primary Education Studies, Mizjin Atma. Simone Hazel Bullard. Lydia Maria Burnett. Gina Hurry. Amy Rachel Howe Little. Tegan Eunice Moore. Lucy May Wickens. Danielle Courtney Woods. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, Social Work, Daniela Elizabeth O. Akani Oso. Josephine Donnelly Edmonds. Leanne Marie Shannon. Charlotte Eloise Wright. For the award of Postgraduate Certificate, Learning and Teaching Higher Education, Natasha Lane. For the award of Postgraduate Certificate in Education, Khalida Begum. Esme Bloomfield. Madeline Baldero. Andrew Brown. Marina Camus. Amalia Canindo Shringhini. Catherine Chapman. Francesca Corley. Amy Elizabeth Davis. Rianne Davis Day. Jade Dean. Hannah Dove. Hannah Eagles. Stacy Elbro. Rachel Goff. Annalise Hare. Melanie Hettle. Hanika High. Beth Jackson. Elliot James. Chloe Jones. Shabana. Nina Kitson. Jessica Lancaster Pages. Charlotte Morphew. Holly Nash. Emma Norris. Andrew Osborne. Cecile Pruel. Tracy Pusey. Samuel Robinson. Syed Shan. Jennifer Sarah Elspeth Twist. Jacob Koshy. For For the award of Master of Arts, Social Work, Carol Achi. Alisa Hamed. Alison Dehisai. Jody Ann Honig. Temilolu Funke Popula. For the award of Bachelor of Science with Honours, Operating Department Practice, Kobe Bilen. Justine Nakafiro. For the award of Diploma of Higher Education, Paramedic Studies, Gloija Perry. Sarah Ridley. For the award of Bachelor of Science with Honours, Paramedic Science, Greta Louise Balfour. Leah Charlie Daniels. Robin James Emmons. Lucy Joy Field. Charlotte Pamela May Forrest. Kaylee Kaylin. Liam James David Krolinski. Joe Morrison. Jasmine Mudhai. Olivia Alice Page. David Perkins. Lisa Pollington. Joshua Rowe. Teddy Topp. For the award of Master of Science, Public Health, Angeline Nisha Rainey Domen Dieran. For the award of Master of Surgery, MCH Urology, Simona Ippoliti. For the award of Postgraduate Certificate, Medical and Healthcare Education, Valigilia Kitkat. For the award of Master of Science, Medical and Healthcare Education, Anna May Trinidad Maglinta. For the award of Bachelor of Science with Honours, Biomedical Sciences, Ali Bilal Nahli. Ashvin Nirma La S. Waran. Vice Chancellor, it is my pleasure to present those who have been awarded higher research degrees. For the award of Doctor of Philosophy, with a thesis entitled Professional Identity in Integrated Care, a Qualitative Case Study, Fiona Chatton. for the award of Doctor of Philosophy with a thesis entitled Exploring Child Labour, an Examination of Child Trading in Nigeria, Abiodun Blessing Oseyiwu. For the Agritat Award of Doctor of Philosophy, with a thesis entitled Ready to Retreat, an Observational Study of New Registered Nurses in the NHS, an Interpretive Phenomenological Analysis of Experiences and Feelings of 12 Newly Qualified Registered Nurses, Pauline Alberta Kingston. Chancellor, that completes the list of graduates for me to present to you today.
Professor Harrison, thank you. Graduates, many congratulations, very well done. No accidents as you cross the stage, so well done. There'll be a number of your fellow graduates who, for a variety of reasons, are unable to join us for this afternoon's celebrations, but we should still acknowledge their success. So will you please join me in congratulating them on their achievements? Each year, Anglia Ruskin University makes a small number of Student Leader Awards, which recognise, celebrate and reward exceptional contributions to ARU and the wider community through extracurricular activity. Recipients of these awards have exhibited exemplary leadership skills and demonstrate that their work has benefited both their fellow students and the wider communities. This year, only six have been selected for one of these esteemed awards in our July and November ceremonies. And I now call upon Antoinetta Balestra, lecturer in international business, to read the citation for the Student Leader Award for Julia Cieślak.
Julia, a graduate of the BSc International Business Management course, is one of the Vice Chancellor's students leaders for 2022. Through her roles as a course rep and student ambassador, Julia has been an excellent role model for her peers and prospective students, demonstrating a strong work ethic and motivation to support students to continue to meet others during the pandemic. As a student ambassador, Julia supported a student life session for prospective students who don't consume alcohol to inspire students to think beyond the stereotypical university experience and demonstrate university life can be enjoyed by all. She also played a significant part in, developing and delivering the first ever FBL Student of the Year Awards. She worked tirelessly on the project to benefit other students and boost morale during the pandemic. Julia used the employability skills audit to help her identify where to focus her personal development journey. As a result, she took part in Impact 24, which resulted in improved problem solving, negotiation, and influencing skills through working on a real-life societal challenge, pitching her idea, and ultimately winning the challenge with her team. Outside of ARU, Julia volunteers as the publicity officer and committee member of her local cats protection branch, where she is responsible for producing their newsletter, social media, and website, as well as contributing to management decision of the committee. In this role, Julia has also raised over £1,500 for the charity through the organization of several fundraising activities. This was particularly challenging during the pandemic and called on her resilience, perseverance, and adaptability to achieve such an excellent sum. Volunteering and working professionally with a wide range of people have been pivotal in helping Julia secure her first job in charity marketing, and she has recently been successful in securing a more senior position, leading the marketing and communications of another local charity. Julia, we are very proud of you. Well done on being recognized as one of the Vice Chancellor student leaders for 2022. Congratulations.
Julia, many congratulations, but don't go far. We are now nearing the end of our ceremony, but first I should like to ask one of our wonderful new graduates, Julia Cheslak, to come to the podium to propose a vote of thanks on behalf of all of those receiving awards today. Julia.
Vice Chancellor, honoured guests, ladies and gentlemen, fellow graduates. It is my pleasure to offer the vote of thanks today for myself and on behalf of all the students graduating at the ceremony. Today is a milestone in our lives as we celebrate the completion of our degrees at Anglia Ruskin. It is a day that I'm sure many of us looked forward to and imagined during difficult times when our studies challenged us. Each of our experiences have been different and brought individual challenges. Assignments and exams are a given at university. However, the challenge of time management, maintaining a social life, working part-time, or being a parent or carer is something that requires commitment, determination, and hard work. Despite our individual journeys being unique, we are all graduating richer in knowledge, skills, and networks that we will build upon as we continue with an education or begin exciting new careers. Anglia Ruskin will remain a common connection for us all, a united students from all parts of the world coming to Cambridge to pursue their passions at university. As graduates, I'm sure many of us will reflect back on our time at Anglia Ruskin as we begin to implement the knowledge and skills acquired during our studies in our new endeavours. On behalf of all graduates, I would like to extend thanks to all the senior staff, lecturers, and staff behind the scenes. Our time at Anglia Ruskin would not have been the same without the incredible support and opportunities you have given us. Beyond contributing to our academic achievements, you have helped us develop in so many ways as individuals. No matter how big or small your contribution, you have all played a role in making our time at university the best it could be. I would also like to thank those who are here today celebrating with us, our friends, families, colleagues, and guests who have witnessed and supported our journeys. The motivation and guidance you have given, alongside patience and the belief that we would succeed, is truly appreciated and has undoubtedly been a key contributor to our success. As the graduation ceremony comes to a close, I would like to wish everyone all the best for the future and congratulate you on graduating from Anglia Ruskin University. Thank you.
Julia, thank you, and very well done. I now call for one final time on the Vice-Chancellor to address the new graduates. Vice-Chancellor.
So now, please, can I ask all those who have been presented to me here on the stage this afternoon, can you please stand? As Vice-Chancellor of Anglia Ruskin University, I hereby admit you to the degrees, diplomas, and awards for which you have been presented to me today. As a member now of the community of scholars, take all that you have learned into society and uphold the values of freedom of thought and scholarship. Our warmest congratulations to you all.
And that brings us to the end of our ceremony, and I hereby declare proceedings closed. Can I now ask everybody who is able to stand for the academic procession? Thank you.
Thank you.